What is life without मिठाई? And what is मिठाई if it's not chocolate? मैं इनफैक्ट अपनी चॉकलेट्स को बच्चों से छुपा कर अपनी अलमारी में लॉकर में रखती हूँ और अपनी ज्वेलरी को फ्रीजर में. Today we're going to make a dessert, the magic chocolate flower. We start it with making a brownie, a little bit of butter and some sugar. We need some maida. Every time you bake a cake, you will either have baking powder or soda bicarb, and they really help your cake to rise. I'm going to also add cocoa. We're going to leave this here because you want to activate the flour and the baking powder and the cocoa. So you're going to add one egg at a time. In baking, every time you introduce one new ingredient, there is something different that happens to your bake. And you immediately see that the texture changes. Vanilla extract for that lovely chocolate flavor in the brownie. I'm going to be adding chocolate flavored syrup. Now I'm going to give this all a good whisk. Add our dry ingredients to the wet ingredients. And I'm just going to fold this. Our brownie batter is ready and it's time for us to put it into a baking tin and bake it in our oven. This is parchment paper. What I've done is cut the sides diagonally, and now into this goes my chocolate brownie batter. Just push it to the corners of your baking tray. This brownie of ours has to bake at 180 degrees for 30 to 35 minutes. And now we come to the delicate part of this yummy dessert. It's making the petals for our magical chocolate flower. The first thing I'm going to get out to the table is our acetate paper. So we've started this whole process by melting the chocolate. So you bring it up to 40 degrees and then for you to work with it, you need to bring down the temperature of this chocolate to about 28 to 30 degrees, which means you temper the chocolate, and when it is well tempered is when you can actually work with it. So basically, when you're tempering chocolate, you need to temper it either on a marble top or you need to temper it on a stainless steel top. Marble is cool and it helps in the tempering of chocolate, and so is steel. So if you want to know if your chocolate is tempered, you basically take a little. It's holding its shape, which means we are now ready to put it back into our bowl and to start shaping it. This has really cooled down so well that when I put this into the other chocolate, it is just going to bring the temperature to exactly what I want. This is the base of my flower, and now the petals. This has to become a nice hard base. I'm going to put this into my fridge. It is now absolutely ready for me to shape it. So I'm going to start cutting my petals. This is my petal stencil that I've cut out in order to make these petals. Very carefully, I'm going to roll this onto this pipe. We are putting the sellotape on the acetate paper. The chocolate is on the inside. The reason we have done this is because now our petals are going to be turned like this, molded on this PVC pipe. And now I'm going to be putting this into the freezer so that I get these beautifully curved petals for my magic flower. The before I start with my creme anglaise, I'm going to get my brownie out of the oven because it is baked. It is beautiful, and I'm going to leave it here to cool. So now I'm going to start with our creme anglaise. Our creme anglaise is basically like a base custard. You have eggs and sugar that need to be whisked and kept in one separate bowl. I'm just going to give this a nice whisk. In another nice non-stick, on not too high a flame, you take some milk, pour it, add to it the vanilla stick, and then some cream. This looks ready. Take this vanilla out. Take this off the fire now. And in a slow, steady stream, pour this onto my egg yolks. That's simultaneously going to cook the egg yolks and make this a nice, yummy custard. Just remember to do this really carefully and really quick. Add this back into my pan. I'm going to put this back on and on a low flame, cook this custard down. This texture is now becoming a little thicker. I'm going to leave this to cool now. So the first thing I need to do is put my base. This goes in the center. Now I'm going to take my cooled brownie cake and just cut into it. This is my whipped cream. Just going to arrange my strawberries. I come to the intricate part of this magical flower. Just very carefully cut the sellotape away. I'm just going to peel this acetate paper off. You basically unmold these petals one by one. So I'm going to start with my first petal very carefully. Put the base into this chocolate and then fix this here at the end. And now I'm going to put some cooling spray so that this chocolate just stays. It's a lot of hard work, a lot of precision, and yes, it's very, very time consuming. This magic flower really has magic qualities. I'm going to go right ahead and feed it to me. Do take a look at the recap and come right back.
Magic chocolate flower. For the brownie, in a clean bowl, take 150 grams of butter, 300 grams of sugar, mix it well using a blender. In a separate bowl, take 300 grams of all-purpose flour, half teaspoon of baking powder, 300 grams cocoa powder. Now add 4 eggs, blend it well, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. 100 ml of chocolate syrup for extra flavor. Now add the dry ingredients to the wet ones and gently fold it into itself. Take a baking tin and place a sheet of butter paper over it. Gently add the batter to the tray and bake it in a preheated oven at 180 degrees for 30 to 35 minutes. To make the flour, you'll need 2 sheets of acetate paper along with 500 grams of tempered compound chocolate. It needs to be 28 to 30 degrees for you to be able to work with it. Once your chocolate is at the right temperature, first make a nice thick circular disc which will act as your base. Cool in the freezer for at least 10 to 15 minutes. Then spread some more chocolate onto another sheet and cut out your petal shape using a petal stencil. Roll your acetate sheet around a PVC पीवीसी पाइप एंड स्टिक द एंड्स विद अ सेलो टेप. फ्रीज दिस फॉर 10 टू 15 मिनट टू मेक योर क्रेम ऑंग्ले. इन अ क्लीन बोल विस्क टुगेदर 75 ग्राम्स ऑफ शुगर एंड 5 एग योक्स. इन अ नॉन स्टिक पैन ऑन अ मीडियम फ्लेम एड 250 ml ऑफ फुल क्रीम मिल्क, 1 वेनिला बीन, 150 ग्राम्स ऑफ क्रीम. केयरफुली एड द लिक्विड इन अ स्टेडी स्ट्रीम टू द एग योक्स. नाउ एड द मिक्सचर बैक इन टू द पैन ऑन अ स्लो फ्लेम एंड कुक द कस्टर्ड डाउन. Place your base in the center of your serving plate. Cut into the brownie using a mold and place it in the center of the base. Add whipped cream and strawberries as topping. Now carefully demold the petals of the flower and use some molten chocolate to stick it to the base. Pour the piping hot creme anglaise on the side and watch the magic unfurl.